do you know every single bitch that I know? Why can't you just shut your mouth and take the high road? Fuck if I know. That's that Chicago. South, south, side.
Let's get the people what they want.
We doing this?
We doing it, man. Should I get the recording? Oh, it is going. Oh, hey.
This is Jungle Beats Radio, Australia's plug to the best hip-hop and music in the world, or we hope we can one day be. You can find us on our check. We just made the Instagram and Twitter for Jungle Beats Radio, so you can hit us there, and Facebook as well, mm-hmm. if you want to see other content and previews. But we are about to do the long-awaited, the highly requested. It feels like thousands of people have been asking us.
Millions of people! Countries, continents, even planets have been asking us to do this.
I have.
The Pink Guy self-titled album, Pink Guy. His first body of work under Pink Guy. We're doing it. God damn it. Right now, okay?
People have spoken.
It's 37 tracks. Now, some people may not even have the full version. On Bandcamp, it's not the full version. He had to delete some or something, so I found the full version he wanted everybody to hear. 37 tracks, 55 minutes, actually shorter than Pink Season. Some people be saying it's tamer. It's not
people
as intense.
People saying it's tamer, but obviously the people that like the first, like, oh, the first album is better because,
But we'll just firstly, we've got to do some housekeeping. A huge thank you to every single person. I'm looking at the video right now.
Yeah.
It's 420,000 views.
420.
17k likes, and don't forget the dislikes. That's 2,000. Even to hear, put 2,000 people in a room. 2,000 people don't even fuck with you. That's great.
We got haters, man.
Oh, man, but like.
Did you see that awesome comment about, like, you couldn't tell whether we were, like. It was funny. Just delete what I just
said. One of the top ones is I look like Lucio. I didn't know who that was.
I showed you from Overwatch.
He had to show me.
And everyone's, yeah.
I feel that. I thank you. That's a compliment. He looks kind of cool. I fuck with him. Yeah, huge thank you to every single person. First off, look, fast forward it if you don't want to hear us say thank you and just appreciate you. Otherwise, yeah, we're really appreciative. And even the video of other Joji's other songs, we're going to come up. We're going to do more of his music.
Right. Over time, we're going to get to all of it.
Now, for those understandably shitting on me in the comments section, the hundreds of people, I just want to address this. Look, yeah, I took it seriously. That's how I take every album seriously, because that's how I approach the music.
Especially when you have no idea who the artist is.
Right. And that's kind of the beauty of what made the video what it was.
Because no one else would really go into it. Well, most people that reacted to it knew exactly what I knew what I was getting into.
Yeah.
You had no fucking idea.
And I think the things that were criticized on is part of the thing that made it so successful or so revered and popular and entertaining. I don't have the same sense of humor as you guys. Like, we don't have the same sense of humor. This is not something, like, I would seek out and listen to myself.
Have you gone back to it at all?
I have.
What'd you go back to?
You want to know what I went back to?
Oh, no. Can I guess what it is? Suck my dick. You ain't shit. You ain't shit. That one?
I did.
Or, where are my bitches at?
That was the one. Now, you know why that was the one? You don't want to see my response to every single motherfucker talking, every single tough guy in the YouTube comments with their anonymous profile pictures and their made up names. You know, I got one thing. We just got one thing. I love all of you. Mm. Just got one thing.
Come on!
Suck my dick. You ain't shit. You ain't shit.
That's all I gotta say. So we can't get to all the comments. So that is my response to all the comments.
No, shut the fuck up.
Who got a little issue here with JBR. That's I'm a little tired now. All right. That's my response. Now, after the sucking of dick has been done,
thy cometh forward.
Oh, I thank you for guys. Actually, like on a more serious note, I checked the artist out. I checked out like trying to get understand Pink Eye and Joji a little more.
As in like his, like how he behind the scenes sort of thing. Like it's all a character. He like, he just does it because he enjoys it, man. He
I didn't know that. Now I listened to a portion of the his interview with the needle drop, Anthony Fantano, as people requested. I checked it out.
I didn't even know they did an interview.
He did a while ago. Same with injury reserve. So check that joint.
Shout out Papa Frankie.
And what I realized, what's so fascinating is it is a character.
Mm-hmm.
It's as if it's like,
as if he's got a multi-split personality, man. It's that crazy.
And he said it, like, he holds next to none of the beliefs Pink Guy actually holds, because it's like, it's some satire character. Like, it's like a comedy routine he's doing.
Mm-hmm.
That's what's like, oh, shit. It's a comedy routine. I didn't know I was sitting down for a comedy show. I'm not going to heckle a guy coming up for a comedy show, because I know the jokes are jokes. I know they're jokes.
True.
And that's my fault, you know? One thing I want to point out, he said the fun part is when people don't get it. And this is where people like me come in. This is what George Miller, him said himself.
I really hope he's watched that video and be like, this is what I do this shit for.
Right.
That's the
fun part. Because he said it gives him a bit of a chuckle because they're too dense to figure it out or even consider that maybe it's a character. And that was me. I was too dense to figure it out.
You can admit this stuff, man.
100%. And it makes sense why I got so many people like coming at me, and that's fine. I got no problem.
Shout out to fuckers.
But yeah. All right.
Where are we gonna do this?
Yeah, let's do it. Sorry, enough time has been used. You go. Excuse me, y'all been waiting for it.
Pink Guy, self-titled.
We're doing it. We're 37 doing it, tracks.
Jungle motherfucking beats.
Holler at me.
Yeah, let's go.
Track one. Ramen King. Produced by Leo.
35 cents a pack, 3 for a dollar. Unbelievable pricing, that's the future of a blue collar worker. And I'm talking about ramen. The shit'll fill you up when you're feeling like an African. Come back when you're in the state that I'm in and say hi to my homeboy Top Ramen.
That's not bad, man. Simple beat, spitting some bars, having a bit of fun, nothing too over the top.
I'm chilling.
This is way more tame than
Nickel Ball on a Pussy. that track title caught me.
Ha, Nickel Ball on a Pussy.
Hey, Bows. Hey, Bows. I get it now, man. I like it. Hey, Bows. okay. Track two. These are all relatively short tracks. Track two, Peanut Butter.
Peanut butter on my balls, let the dog lick it. Peanut butter on my balls, let the dog lick it.
Balls!
Peanut butter on my balls, let the dog lick it. Peanut butter on my balls, let the dog lick it. Peanut butter on my balls, let the dog lick it. Peanut butter on my balls, let the dog lick it. Peanut butter on my balls, let the dog lick it. Peanut butter on my balls, let the dog lick it. My balls, let the dog lick it. Peanut butter on my balls, let the dog lick it. Peanut butter on my balls, let the dog lick it.
Got peanut butter on my balls.
That's some hot trash right there.
That's A grade. That's not A grade.
I did like the home brand gonad line, because repping that Australian, you know?
I thought he was going to go in that direction. I didn't say it, but I thought he was like, yeah, because I thought a family guy used that joke before. Yeah, you know, people have done that. People have done that.
Put peanut butter on their balls.
Yeah, that comes from like some real shit.
I mean,
I'm sure there's some people who are watching this have done that shit.
I mean, how do you know that squirrel poo was nutty and chunky? Like, would you have to like have pictures of squirrel poo? Would you go to America and touch some squirrel poo? That's the real question.
Track three, it's gonna be a good one. Anal beads.
whoa! You sure it's a ukulele?
That is, yes.
They kind of coming at you.
No, that's 100% a ukulele. I know this.
I broke a dog's neck.
In the darkest of times, ass is bleeding, ass is bleeding.
That's just dumb. That was boring for me.
Yeah, it was boring as fuck.
Except he what I appreciate, the man can sing and he has talent.
He can sing and he does make quite. I mean, if you can make me fall asleep while mentioning anal beads, then
like really, like I've never heard someone harmonize so well to something so like superficially beautiful. Crude, right?
Bro, anal beads are a beautiful thing.
Right. Oh, sorry. Fuck.
You should buy some sometime.
Oh.
Experiment.
Nah, I'm good. Track 4.
Alright, let's go.
Big Mama. It's a good movie.
Big Mama, selling narcotta. How much do it cost, bitch? None zip nada. Rumble, policia, ain't no drama. Fresh new Adidas for the newborn stamina. Flow so pretty, I would turn around and fuck it. Asian girl screams, that's a Bangkok ruckus. Crack bite, but I crack bite vocally. Metal. Fuck her in the ass, less humps than a camel. Yo, rid of this fictitious little right. Kiddo that rinse dishes, blow kisses to bad girls. The brain deteriorates and I go insane.
In the membrane, insane. In the membrane.
Insane in the brain!
No, that's really, that's the most bars I've heard.
That's the best track so far.
Yeah, that's the best track, like.
Some good lines, like, she's got less humps than a camel.
He actually seems like a witty guy, like.
He's got good punchlines.
I don't know how he's right, so I would be curious to see how he actually writes, and like, whether there's something he just, I don't know.
If we got him in for an interview, we'd be able to find out.
Yeah, no, we'd love to, but, yeah. The management has to respond to my email first. I don't know, Frank. You know, you always wonder, like, making a video like we did or just reacting to this, his stuff. Like, who knows what he would have thought? Would have fucked these guys or ha-ha or, like, I don't know. It'd be cool. Yeah.
It'd be dope.
Yeah, it'd be really dope. Like, generally, like, we'd love to talk music and I bet with him. Anyway. That's the power. Track 6. Bitches Ain't Shit.
And hop into my ride and make a quick run. Bitches ain't shit. Man, fuck these bitches. Take the knots and suck the dick.
Yeah.
He's
that actually he gave can me sing. That gave me some Outkast Idlewild vibes. Have you heard Idlewild? The way that
I
he was
heard
harmonizing,
the song.
The harmonizing layering was very similar to Idlewild.
That's big props. I ain't got much to say on that.
I just like the way that he had his voice hit notes, like he was hitting them good.
I wonder how he learned ukulele. It's a very unique instrument to learn. Track 7, Dick Pays Rent featuring Pink Guy. I don't understand, featuring Pink Guy isn't this whole thing. Him?
I don't know.
I don't understand.
Maybe it's just like him just.
Or another character, another. I don't know.
Fucking hard to believe. I hang dogs from trees so I can raise the roof. I turn around way too fast and knock things off the shelf with my dick. Now it's really red and blue like Lilo and Stitch. Now it's really starting to itch. Hepatitis. It drops like my balls at the age of 12. My nipple shrivels up like a dehydrated elf. I shot an old man in the knee. And my dick pays rent. And my dick pays rent. So I got a little story that'll rattle your tits. They call me Mr. Pants Pants with these nasty rants. They wanna get a little Mr. Magic Man. They want a little fire from the land of pants. So I'll give a little help from these faggots, man. I shake things up like Parkinson's.
Well, that was pretty mean.
Yeah, well, you're pretty fucking disgusting.
Ooh.
I fuck with that.
Yo, beats hard, spinning bars, and I love the line about like he hangs dogs because like he could from the roof.
Oh my god, like I missed that.
That was a great line. That was a lot of bars in that, and then he switched up the flow.
Yeah, he switched up the flow.
The hook was, you know, lyrically, but the, like it just sounded good. That was a good track.
I could see why people be asking for like for Joji to be making some real shit though. Oh no, sorry, we know it's all real. Other type of music that is more serious.
Yo, man, you've said it. You can't cut it. People are going to know. You're gonna get flamed again, man.
Flames are inevitable. Track 7, Birth of Bowels.
Boss, please give me the pussy, boss.
Please, give me the pussy, please.
Boss, please.
Boss, please, boss. Please, give me the pussy.
You go to the hospital.
That's a 20-second track. I want to. Is there a YouTube video on the birth of Boss? On like what actually happened?
The birth of Boss. Or maybe that's where the hey boss comes from. That's what that video that clip is. The birth of the boss.
Oh, okay. Let's have a look. It says, "Can I have
pizza, please?
Can I have pizza, please?" On Filthy Frank.
Let's watch it. Hold on.
Hello, how may I help you?
Hello, hey boss. Hey boss. Can I have a pizza, please?
One more time.
Can I have a pizza, please? Can I have a pizza, please?
Have a one time.
Yes, boss. Hey, boss. Yes, boss. Can I have a pizza, please?
I'm sorry, I don't understand what you're saying.
Hey, can I have a pizza, please?
I'm sorry, I can't understand what you're saying.
Hey, boss, can I have a pizza, please?
Hold on, let me see if I can get somebody on the cell.
Boss, please, I have a cancer, boss. Boss. Hey, boss.
Thanks for calling, I apologize. How may I help you?
Hey, boss. Hello?
Hello?
Hey, hello, can I have a pizza, please?
Pizza? What kind of pizza?
Yeah, can I have a pizza, please?
What kind?
Pizza.
No.
Can I have a pizza, please? Boss?
Yeah, plane. Do you
want
a plane?
Mouse, I have a cancer. Mouse, can I have a pizza, please?
Yes, you can.
Can I have a pizza, please? Can I have a pizza, please? can I have a pizza, please? Hey, Mouse.
That's
the best.
Great.
Godly.
That's amazing.
Right.
Track 8, Do the Salamander. What's a salamander? Isn't that an animal?
It's an amphibian. It's sort of like a newt, but bigger.
A newt?
Do you know what a newt is?
The fuck is a newt?
Do you know what an axolotl is?
Stop making shit up, man.
I'm not. They're all amphibians. Do you know what... imagine a lizard, but more with like frog-like... Like what's some slimy skin, but with really bright colours. Like, say, like, a green with, like, red spots. Black with red spots. Like, really bright red spots. That's a salamander. Google salamander right now. I'm not letting you press a song until you look at a salamander.
Hey, boss. That's cool. It looks like it's smiling.
Yeah, they're really smart. They're kind of similar to a Mexican walking fish.
All right, this is not the fucking National Geographic show. Let's go. Do the salamander.
Let's do it. Hell on this. Yes!
Salamander.
Yeah. So at least I've educated now into what a salamander and its cousins are like.
Mm-hmm.
Trash. Next track. This is funny because normally you're saying next track.
Woo! Alright, track 9. Some people may suffer from erectile dysfunction.
Is this SpongeBob SquarePants?
Oh, I fuck with this. This is. Oh.
It sounds like it.
Yeah, I fuck with it.
My dick don't stand like a fat kid in PE. The only time it's active when I'm in the bathroom pee. I'm like a Nazi with a broken arm. I gotta get it up, be like this. If you want respect, then hop off my dick. Ironically, I go hard, though.
Yo, that beat was fucking flame. I did not expect that at all.
Yeah, no. Production, obviously, is his strongest suit. He's talented.
Yo, I thought we were going to get, like, some SpongeBob SquarePants laughing high pitched. Then he just switched that beat up and...
And who can use a shotgun? It sounds like a shotgun. Maybe
I thought
not.
He was going to keep shooting it, but then he just reloaded it for the next track, like the rest of the track.
Who can use a shotgun so well as a sample? Track 10.
That was dope.
Fried Rice, produced by Bezza.
Fried rice, fried rice, bitch. You wanna play your cards, but gotta mold the dice, bitch. Cheeks are fried, chopstick, age flow. I ain't about the oven or the microwave grills, but I know a little bit about the culinary skills required. If you wanna roll with a frying pan, gotta fly with the heart of a Chinaman. Anybody got another method in the pantry? Can suck my dick, shit tastes like vagina, man. I ain't no Gordon Ramsay, but I make the best damn rice and pansies. A mixed with me came from Japan, see. Stir, fry, stir, fry.
Give me some of that.
Yo.
Give me some of that.
Blodo. The beat's like, just, you know. That was cool.
You know what it reminded me of? When that fan did a remix of...
The What's Goody mix with the...
Injury Reserve. What's Goody with... What was the other song?
I think it was... Rice Balls. Was it? No. It was... Fuck, it was Dumplings. I'm pretty damn sure it was Dumplings.
He did a fucking amazing job.
Yo, shout out to...
I'm gonna find him.
Yeah.
Someone made a remix of What's Goody, Injury Reserve, and Dumplings because of... I mentioned how similar, like, they sounded.
Yeah, we just started rapping it.
Just for fun. And this man done...
posted and created a track... based on it.
With the Injury Reserve over the Dumplings.
And it's fucking dope.
It works. It's so similar, isn't it?
Yo, what's goody? I'm the hottest rap. My city, I got all the sounds. Got plenty, you should ask around. My city, get to work.
Hey, anybody who shows us love, we're gonna shout you out.
Yo.
On Twitter, I am MellowYellowZero. I'll put you up on the screen. Shout out to you. None of you use your goddamn real name. Use your real names, man. God damn
Maybe
it.
Maybe his real name is Mellow Zero, bro. All
right, well, I appreciate you. It's really creative and it's dope, and I have it in my actual iTunes, so
yeah.
Thank you.
Much
Let's
love.
Go. Lego! Man, next track. 11, Fuck the Police, NWA cover.
Underground, a young, forgot it back.
Can you bleep the N-word?
Well, he's not black.
But he said the N-word. Pixies. Multiple times.
I said,
yeah, sure.
But he's playing a character, at least still is.
Cause I ain't the one for a punk motherfucker with the badge. I don't even know if they fags or what. I search him Nick down and grabbing his nuts.
And I said, yeah. I said, fuck the police.
He sounds nice.
It sounds nice. I was a bit bored, but I think it would be something that very pink guy like to actually just, like, halfway through to stop bleeping it out because it'd just be funny.
Right. So, yeah, I wonder why he bleeped it out in this one and not Pink Season. I mean, obviously this came first.
Maybe he just didn't like using it around this time.
Yeah, maybe. You know, who knows?
Because nothing's been as vulgar so far as what we've heard already from...
No, exactly. So we're desensitized to it in a lot of ways. So it's like, oh, this is, like, very tame. So far. But the next track, 12, is titled Kill Yourself, so...
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah.
Number one, shove it up your ass and make it number two.
Oh.
Ladies getting mad in the comments and I'm hearing it. You think it was a typo with these...
Yeah, I know.
It was alright. It was more just soothing.
Bored.
Yeah, I'm pretty bored.
Yeah.
Wake me up, bro.
Track 13. Balls.
These bitches wanna suck my balls.
These bitches wanna suck my balls.
Club Banger 2000.
That was fucking on fire. That Clubbanger 2000.
Clubbanger.
That was fucking great.
That was great. I showed a few people that and they lost their shit. They lost their shit.
It's the best, man. It was fucking DJs.
Hey.
Fucking. Alright. Track 14, Frank Says. Says. That's weird.
Shut the fuck up. Someone says shut the fuck up. Pull your hands to the sky.
Get the fuck up. Frank says get the fuck up. I keep it tight like a nun's ass. Get it? Y'all fuckers go home and masturbate to Reddit.
Okay.
Flow dirty like I got a bad tooth decay. Yeah, shout outs to Salamander Man for taking my hot pocket this morning. I'm gonna fucking kill you.
Maybe Salamander's a friend of his.
Maybe.
Maybe he was the guy he was doing the Hey Boss thing with. I don't know. But anyway, that's a classic beat from Pharaoh Monch, and also, yeah, there were some good bars in there.
That was a dope track.
My favorite bars on about the Letterman not being on tonight. I can't remember exactly what he said, but that was dope. It was good.
Top five track there so far for me.
Aight.
This is a short 20-second one. This is titled track 15. See, it's called Crazy Nigga, but he puts obviously the N word in the title.
Wait, so the N-word's there?
Yeah, the N-word's there, so it's... and he bleeped it out before. I don't know.
My dick gets bigger cause I'm a crazy nigga. My dick gets bigger cause I'm a crazy nigga. My dick gets bigger cause I'm a crazy nigga. My dick gets bigger cause I'm a crazy nigga.
That's A-grade trash. Right there.
I don't know, man. I could listen to that a few more times.
Repeat.
No, don't. Please don't.
Track 16, Bad Words. So the point was, he explicitly put the N-word there. Didn't bleep it before he did. I don't know.
No idea.
I'm just...
You're right. Fucking with this.
Track 16, Bad Words.
You're a total faggot. You should kill yourself. You should kill yourself. You should kill yourself. You should kill yourself. You should kill yourself.
Oh, I'll fuck with the next track.
Can I guess what it's called?
Yeah.
Buffalo Wings.
Watermelon Pussy.
That's what do you mean, Watermelon Pussy?
What?
Watermelon.
What am I missing?
Mate. It's Watermelon.
I thought that was you're being like a joke, like that's some type of pun.
No, there is some more jokes to it. I just can't think of them right now.
It's Watermelon.
It's Watermelon.
You're not serious.
I'm completely serious.
The fruit. The fruit.
Yeah.
The fruit Watermelon.
Bro, I keep Watermelons to keep me floating.
What?
Watermelon.
You're fucking with me, man. You gotta be fucking with me. You gotta be fucking with me. Anyway, that's the best type of pussy, Watermelon Pussy. Actually, Pineapple Pussy. You ever tasted that?
Yo, Grapefruit Pussy with a bit of sprinkle of salt's my shit.
Salt.
Yo, Grapefruit Pussy and salt. Sprinkle that shit on there. She be moaning. She be loving that. And Grapefruit got that bitterness and acidicness. Trust me.
You don't want an acidic pussy.
Yo, shove half a grapefruit in her pussy. Sprinkle some salt in that bitch. Dinner is served.
Disease and the antidote is inside the pussy. People don't like me cause I touch them. Mad pussy like Tom and Jerry. I eat pussy like I have diabetes and the insulin is inside my BP. Yes, you know this. If
if pussy was the vegetable, I'd grow it. That pussy's so good that it's got me singing a little song, and it goes like, give me that pussy, yeah. Give me that pussy. They call me the pussy man. They call me the pussy man. Oh, pussy man, where you gonna run to? They call me the pussy man. And pussy man, where you gonna run to? Eat the pussy like a watermelon. Oh. Yeah. Eat the pussy like a watermelon. Oh. Eat the pussy like a watermelon. Yeah. Slurp, slurp. Slurp, slurp. Eat the pussy like a watermelon. Yeah. Eat the pussy like a watermelon. Oh. Eat the pussy like a watermelon. Yeah. Slurp, slurp. Slurp, slurp.
That's the only way to eat it.
Man, eat the pussy like a watermelon, man.
Shut up. But that, you know, when he said, like, he like, pussy's so good, something, and he paused. I can grow it.
That was a great line.
That was great, because it's like, what's going to come? And he just said something like,
so you know, like, think, like, it'd be a vegetable, obviously, but then it's a fruit, so.
Oh, it's interesting. Next track 18, that was a dope song, by the way. I like that. That was really funny. Track 18 is called Gay Mickey. Now, we experienced the Mickey and Goofy in the previous, in the preceding album, Pink Season.
What was it? Goofy's Trial.
Goofy's, that was
which
fucking...
is, which is all his voices.
That's really great. I just thought it was really creative. It had me totally engaged in that song. I was like, what's going to happen?
Up to the very end.
Yeah, I want more of that. I want a whole movie. Anyway, Gay Mickey.
You want a middle sex? You want a middle sex? You want a real sex?
What? You want anal sex, I think.
You want a real sex?
Stop.
What? You want a real sex?
That's just a fucking group of guys just fucking chilling and obviously getting high or getting drunk or whatever.
Yeah, and just
the mics are on.
I know the feels.
That'd be much funny if you were there. Track 19. It's okay to eat whale.
Rice and soy, oh boy, wanna come up to the ocean, run the deep, and the boys now whales. Dulce, despite spilling the oil like it was estrogen, despite killing the millions of Middle Eastern men, despite decency to save another human being, waste time, save creatures from the sea.
This is a bit weird.
I was listening to what he was saying, and that was kind of the more, like, it was still it was like a sarcastic, serious track.
Yeah, exactly. He was, like, trying to be serious about it, but, like, also... like banging it in a way,
and it's like, yeah, it's okay to eat whale. We're focusing on like saving these whales, but then he references like I don't know wars and some other, you know, social political issues. In kind of a sarcastic manner, it's like, come on guys, what are we doing? Focus on the whales. So yeah, I don't know if you heard that, but that's what I took from it in that short song. Track 20. Jungle Boy Part 1.
Yeah, man, we know he's dumb.
Yeah. Let me tell you about a thing or two.
17 tracks left, 16 tracks
left. Ride a Subaru or
wait,
do some gay shit.
27 tracks?
37. Anything regarding dicks ain't my cup of tea, cause I love the poon. No? So fucking slick that slick Ricky would slit his wrist and insist that I should be the slickest bitch since the Genesis.
Ooh.
Since the Genesis? Yeah, since the Genesis, cause I'm the bestest at good grammar in these sentences.
The bestest. He slowed the beat down the entire song.
Yeah, he did. What the hell is this?
Ooh, I like this.
This is nice.
You can find me in the jungle, bitch. In the jungle, bitch. In
yeah.
The jungle, fuck being humping, bitch. Sorry, this beat is reserved for the Joji album.
Are you for real?
I hope so. That was a dope beat. Favorite line from that track, though? I'm the best, des. Is it still going?
Yeah, he can talk. There's nothing, man. It's just animals fucking.
Oh yeah, this is, I'm the best est of grammar in these sentences. It's just funny because bestest est isn't a word. If you didn't know.
He's reserving it for the Joji album. This was released in when? In 2014.
So it's been a long time coming. So, I'm sorry you're gonna edit out.
Y'all must be hungry, huh?
So I'm sorry you're gonna edit out these burps, man.
They're staying in. You're gonna keep it 100. You gotta
count all my burps in this video, and top comment better be how many burps there were. You better be correct. If you write 3,000, there better be 3,000 burps in this video.
We're not gonna count. Track 21, Douchebag.
I guess you just send that track. You just send that track to your friends if they're a douchebag, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, like, why else was that made? Like,
but now he's gonna shut the fuck up, so you wouldn't never ever send that.
Well, I mean, you got a variety of songs really to send to people you hate, dislike, and want to fuck with. So
this album is a lot tamer than Pink Season.
100%.
So that's why I reckon when the new album came out, people were just like, he's taking that next step forward.
Mm-hmm.
Like, this is like our surprise factor. Like, if we did it the other way around, it'd be different. But we're doing it the opposite way.
Yeah. That's not non-conventional, obviously.
But we're seeing where the growth comes from between the albums.
And I can see it, obviously.
I'm actually probably... I don't know if I'm enjoying it. I find this album boring in patches, but like it's easier to listen to it for the fact that there aren't many lines that make me feel like I should be listening to it.
But those lines are what make it more engaging. They make it more entertaining, and they make the time pass with less kind of consciousness, with less... I don't know, you know?
No, I feel you.
Track 22. Ladies Man.
After a hot summer's day, I like to come back to my house and break my dog's neck. I get more pussy than animal control. I keep it real hot like the spices in my asshole. Roses are red and violets are blue. Can I see your pussy? I shot a... What do you call a girl with no legs?
What?
Disabled.
What do you call a girl with no legs?
Disabled. Do you know what the original joke is?
No,
what
is it?
What do you call a girl with one leg?
What?
Eileen. What do you call a girl with no legs? No-lean. Well, that's the original joke, but disabled's a lot funnier.
Track 23, FF and the Crew.
I'm an oversized midget with a pocket of shit. Yeah, I like to pee. I'm that one kid who hung your dog from a tree. I just don't like vaccines. I like women, don't get me wrong, but there ain't nothing wrong with a good old-fashioned dick. You can find me outside in the white van, having sex with a pigeon, man. Yeah, and when I'm done with the pigeon, I'll let it fly back to the jungle. Yeah, and it's eatable. He can do it if you stay with him.
Yo, I actually really like the track for the fact that that beat is like an Apollo Brown boom bap beat. It's like a mid to late 90s sort of hip hop beat. Like, you hear like a Fabulous or B.I.G. or a Nas on there during that era, but he's just gone over it.
Isn't that crazy?
In the stupidest way possible.
Isn't that crazy?
It just, the beat with that voice and what he was saying was just fucking hilarious.
He's really challenging, like, any conventional listener who wouldn't know Pink Eye is, he really got like challenges you with by doing that shit.
Like, that's probably the funniest track for me so far. I really found that track hilarious.
And he doesn't even need to make shit rhyme. You notice that? He doesn't care if it fucking rhymes.
He was saying gibberish for like 30 fucking seconds.
I think it was Japanese or Chinese. I can't remember. Japanese. He's Japanese, so it's probably his native language.
It didn't sound Japanese.
But like slurred and like all like distorted and stuff. But I like he doesn't care if it rhymes or not. He's just trying to make
gonna weird. Fuck a pigeon back to the jungle like I can't do
it. I don't know what he did.
I can't fucking do a pigeon noise.
That's terrible, man.
This is next track.
Alright, man. Track 24, Loser.
Some offensive, I'm hopping all fences. You act all hard, but inside you're defenseless.
No way, it's all good.
This is a snoozer right here.
Fucking trash, bro.
I'm ready to sleep on that one.
I couldn't even listen to what he was saying. I was that fucking bored. Yo, I've had drunk one night stands that are more interesting than that.
I'd hope so. Track 25, pussy dough?
I like that pussy dough.
Girl, you know who to call? Smear your shit on my balls.
Here, I ran over my dead dog. But that is okay because I have a new pet and its name is Pussy. Uncle Brad used to touch me. He kept rubbing me and I told him this wasn't a fun game anymore, but he just kept touching me and I hated it.
Uncle Brad is bad.
Bad pussy! Pussy! Bad pussy!
I have a brain tumor
all around. Bad pussy! Bad pussy! Bad pussy!
Oh yeah!
Oh yeah, pussy. Are we safe?
What?
I don't know if we're safe, man.
I don't know if we're safe.
Is he gonna come back?
He's been known, we missed the Easter egg, but then we went back and like it was 5 seconds and nothing in the last album.
How much time do we have?
Right now we're hitting 17 seconds. So, but I like the way he layered the pussy on top of the pussy.
Pussy.
And Uber Pussy in Pink Season was crazy.
Well, this was similar to Uber Pussy.
He loves pussy. Or he loves to talk about
sometimes
pussy.
Sometimes I like to play with my ball.
That's like Uber Pussy at the end. Sometimes I touch
there
my
it is.
So, this, so that is an Uber Pussy part one.
Because
That's the same ending.
Interesting. How go. He keeps the theme.
There we go.
Ain't that some shit? Holy shit.
What?
The track's titled Some Shit.
Some shit?
I just finished the sentence with Ain't That Some Shit. As I was clicking the next track. Y'all will see it. It said some shit. I just when things like that happen,
ain't that some shit? Some
and
shit.
Then as soon as like, he literally finished a sentence with the track in front of me as I was saying it.
So it's like, yo, I wanna watch some TV. I really feel like watching Sesame Street, and then
Sesame Street,
the fucking street.
Like flick the channel. But that's even like
Killable syllables in the pinnacle of innocence. I'm a creepy little rapper coming out the factory. Capture me, I will be the toughest rapper actually. Watch me as I drag my ass to the top gradually. Oh!
I don't know about you, but I love the jazzy soul instrumentation, old school kind of throwback jazz.
I don't like it, I thought it was pretty boring.
I love the instrumentation. Alright. But that's a more serious track. It's like there was nothing like satire there. I feel like that could be on a next album. Or some more, like a...
You know what? He was right. That was some shit.
Track 27. Steve.
Stephen Hawking is here to destroy that pussy. I bet you have never been with a real nigga like me before. Oh, keep going, baby. You are doing great. Yes, Yachtyarn Poo is new from Yachtyarn.
Well, now we know what Stephen Hawking sounds like when he has sex.
Would he have sex?
Well, it'd probably be... I don't know. But it probably wouldn't be what you and me know as, or everybody commonly knows as sex.
I'm going to Google it later. I'm just curious, man. You like crack? Oh. Alright, let's go.
Track 28, Taco Bell.
I know what your problem is.
You got the good old
What?
I don't know. I don't know what that track was about.
Okay.
Some serious trash on this.
Track 29, Took It to the Bottom.
Oh yeah.
Oh shit.
Okay. Yeah,
got it.
Zombie on the track.
Took it in the bottom, now I'm queer. Took it in the bottom, now my whole team queer, yeah. Took it in the bottom, now I'm queer. Took it in the bottom, now my whole team queer, yeah. Bottom, now my whole team queer, yeah.
Like, when he says, now we quit, now the whole team's queer, and you hear this, like, oh!
I didn't even notice that. I was vibing to the beat too much. So, how can he use that instrument? He obviously doesn't charge for this album.
Nah.
Because he can't charge for an album and use someone else's.
Unless you get their blessings, which he most certainly fucking did not. Because he just said that Drake took it with Birdie and Lil Wayne, so.
Oh.
Unless Drizzy's gonna be like, yo, I find that funny, man. Yeah, you put that in your money for that shit. That's what Drake sounds like.
Track 30, Tribute to Ronald. I thought it said Donald. It says Tribute to Ronald.
I want a gay for Donald part 2.
I want another fucking... Oh, I'll tell that later.
Heard of this magic place when the atom bomb crushed a small country in its natural state. Rebuilt
to a fine little real estate.
I really like that ending.
So do I.
That was, rain.
Have you noticed that the songs about food are normally the good ones?
Dumplings was dope, yeah. I mean, yeah, they're standout tracks. They're doing something. I initially don't think of Ronald McDonald. I think Ronald Reagan, the ex-president or previous president of the United States. Obviously not Ronald McDonald.
Mm-hmm. Like, while you're looking it up, they were just making every reference possible to Macca's too.
And I'm like not even listening, and it's like
looking for it.
Anyway.
Yeah, that was good. I like that track. That was cool.
Track 31, we in the home stretch now. You got a friend.
It's trash now. Oh, Toy Story, you heard this? It's Toy Story.
Oh yeah, Frank is back! Oh, my favorite
got
part of the day.
You got a friend in me.
You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me.
Oh man, I'm so glad he's back.
You got a friend in me.
Kill me.
What the fuck?
Why is he Andy's tracks 4 seconds just cuts the music? What type of shit is that? I love Toy Story, man. Shout out to Toy Story. Yo, shout out to Buzz Lightyear, man. Shout out to Buzz Lightyear. Shout out to Woody, man. Shout out to fucking, you know who I love?
Slinky.
Shout out to fucking Potato Man. He's the motherfucking shit.
Nah, man. You know who it's all about?
Who's it about? You probably like in your teenage years when that came out. I was like younger.
No, yeah, no. It would have been pretty young.
Anyway, shout out to Toy Story. That was dope.
So Potato Head was your number one.
Oh man, I love Potato Head. I used to play that little game on the PC, and we had it Windows 98 and shit. Yeah. Oh, I think it was. And we played I played this Toy Story game. I like put Potato Head together, and I played like this Toy Story game on the PlayStation 2, maybe even PlayStation 1. Throwback shit, and that was a lot of fun.
I used to play that game as well.
Yeah, the Toy Story one.
Yeah, was that the one where you're pretty much Toy Story characters, but I remember just running around, you jump on like the
train, third person.
Trains and around.
Right.
Yeah, was that it?
Man, that was some fun
you
shit. You
ride the little toy cars around.
Man, Jungle Beast game and coming soon. I don't really know.
That was the bomb.
Track 32, Who's the Sucker?
I still play with Play-Doh. Yep. We go play basketball in the park. My skin is darker than tree bark. Jim. Who the sucker, man? Okay.
Who the sucker, man? You the sucker, man? Who the sucker, man? Your bitch the sucker, man?
I'm pretty sure 20 out of the 31 tracks I've heard of have been a mention of a dead dog.
Yeah, right. That's real, though.
It's like his thing. But he didn't do it in the next last album.
But I know in Asian culture, like, previously, they would consume dog.
There's a dog show, remember?
Oh, that dog show, but that was a great track, too. But, like, they actually would. Like, it's common among, it's probably still done in some areas of Asia when and other cultures that consume dog.
Yeah.
So I'm sure he's, like, poking fun of his culture through that. Oh, I know how to pronounce this. I'm like, how the fuck do I pronounce this? The words are all fucked up. Okay, track 33. Gimme the pussy, Bows.
Is it all one word?
No, it's four words. Okay. Gimme the pussy, Bows.
Is this really the whole thing the whole time?
How long does it go for?
3 minutes.
Skip a little bit.
That was the whole thing.
It's just
we got through a minute of
like a 20-second thing looped for the whole track.
Yeah, we got through a minute of that loop, and it was like, hold on.
Give me the pussy, boss. Man, you got your boss on point, though.
Boss. Boss.
Some guy commented, bows, like 50 times. You guys don't understand, when you do that, it's YouTube flags the shit. So in the approved comments, you have to approve comments. You saw this. It was like bows times 50.
Yeah.
I approved one of them. Fucking deleted the rest. So I'm like, come on, man.
Come on, man. Let's put shit in our page, man.
Nah, that's all good. Track 34, In the Womb.
Ooh, we're on the home stretch, bro.
Oh, shit!
Go Shadus, it's not your birthday. You just a fetus, so it's not your birthday. There's a high chance that you won't have a birthday. Only 16, climbing in the womb, breathing in the fluids. It takes you 9 months, I'm on my hair protein. And I get a little bigger. In the 1800s, you can find me in the river.
Ha ha ha, 50 laugh. Man, I didn't hear a word he said. I was just thinking, I was trying to rap the 50 verse. My flow, my brought me the dough. That brought me all my fancy things. My whip, my, I can't remember the lyrics. Fuck shit, god damn it, bitch.
But you should love it way more than you hate it.
I thought you'd be happy that I made it.
We're so bad. Talking about being a fetus, and
that was fucking dope. Because he used it. That's Get Rich or Die Trying is why I love hip hop. If that album wasn't released, I don't know where I would be within hip hop.
Be real, man. Pink season, the reason you love hip hop.
Track 35, Friend Zone.
Do you know why?
It sounds very similar. The dog show one.
Yeah. He plays pretty similar.
It's because you're fat. And gay.
I'm never really a fan of these tracks.
There's no such thing as the friend zone. Friend
Why?
Zone.
Because they just sound very similar. Like, sure, he's saying different things that are funny, but like, the ukulele can only do so much.
Yeah.
And it just, it doesn't, it gets repetitive. It's very hard for me to like take it when he's saying what it's just the ukulele.
Yeah.
Like, he could be talking about shitting on a pineapple and then giving it to his mother as like a Valentine's gift. Right. I don't know. Like, I wouldn't be paying attention.
No, I feel that.
Would it be my Valentine?
Hmm?
Nothing.
Oh,
it's
what you...
Filthy Frank!
Hold on. Okay, we're just gonna go. It's 8 seconds.
It's Filthy Frank, bitch!
Was that it?
That was literally a 7 second track.
Was that the last track?
No, there's... Oh, hold up. The next track's 4 seconds, which is the last one.
Let's get some pussy tonight!
That's it. We're done. That was so strange.
Thank fuck for that.
Those last two tracks were combined of 12 seconds. Ooh. Holy shit.
Pink season, I believe, had a lot more, because it was more like in your face and more sort of.
Can I turn this up?
Yeah.
Thanks.
But yeah, I just feel like Pink season had a bit more for it going. Like, I feel the beats were harder.
Mm.
And he took you to another part, which is more excruciating to listen to, which made it a more enjoyable listen in that sense. This album still had its good qualities, but I was bored a lot of the time.
100. Yeah, I feel you. I was not as engaged. Maybe partly because we were desensitized a little bit from listening to Pink Season.
Yeah.
That this album isn't as good as Pink Season.
It's not.
As weird as Pink Season was, I think that's why it was so great.
Well, this still has some, like, you know, some of the qualities of that. Like, it's got sort of the humor, the pussy mentions.
Right.
It's got some of the weird beats, the ukulele, the slower tracks. It's got it's still got a lot of elements. Just, I feel like Pink Season does everything better.
Mm-hmm. I agree. It does it better. It does it more creatively. It does it more humorously. Yeah. It's punchier, like, even though it's long.
The auto-tune's worse. The lines are right. Worse. Like, everything's worse, which is what makes it better.
Yeah. And it's funny to say that, right?
It is.
But it's true for us anyway. I mean, yeah. It's just our perspective.
Like, I feel a lot of people are going to watch this reaction and be like, oh, is it they didn't catch this reference. Why weren't they, like, being more engaged with that? Because we just weren't, it just wasn't as interesting.
And I don't think this video is going to be as interesting to people to watch. It's not going to be as funny. And that's the beauty of accidentally doing what we did.
Yeah,
right?
Because now that we're aware of it, there's no surprise factor.
Right.
I was aware, you weren't, but like...
Now we're both on the same page. And now
we're enjoying this. Like, I'm glad that we're fans of him now.
100%. Yeah. And now we're diving into his music. Who is George Miller? Who is Joji? Oh, shit, this man's prolific.
I probably won't go back to this album, maybe for a track two, but in terms of Pink Season, I go back to Pink Season for 4 or 5 tracks.
I'll go Pink Season.
Yeah.
I put that shit back in my iTunes. You know, I made the joke about the recycle bin, right? Throwing... It's back in there.
Oh, boy.
Yo, but I just want to, real quick, for those who have made it this far, I have actually have a gift for you guys. So you don't... I don't think you know.
What?
I have a gift for them. I'm gonna send them something. So, I run a...
You don't want to see a picture of your dick, right? I know what's
suck
impressive.
My dick.
You ain't shit.
You ain't
my dick.
All right, but for those who've made it to the end, because we like appreciate people who do like, you know, stick with us. I'm gonna be. So I run an e-commerce store called When I See It, and I create and sell music posters and clothing. I'm starting to get into more clothing now.
Yeah.
Right, and so it's basically mainly hip hop stuff. And so there's a bunch of variety. It's actually, there's a link in the description. I don't know if you ever saw it. It's called whenisee.com is the website. And so I sell posters, as I mentioned. And so I'm going to give away, because I'm very thankful for the response we've been getting. And just because I want to give some shit away. It feels good. I want to give something away to thank some people. I'm going to pick followers. I'm just going to pick random followers.
Pick random followers?
I'm going to pick, that's what I'm going to do.
Okay.
I'm going to pick.
Just say, so... Tweet at Jungle Beats Radio and we'll pick you.
You don't even have to tweet us, alright? Just pick.
Okay.
I'm just gonna pick followers, right? So we got there. Obviously J Beats Radio on Twitter and Instagram Jungle Beats Radio. I'm just gonna pick some random followers.
Okay.
Probably a handful, about 3 to 5. I don't know yet. I'm gonna message you and I'm gonna say what post do you want, what item do you want, you get to pick whatever you want, I'm going to send it to you free of charge, wherever you are in the world, you send me your address, and that'll be done as a thank you for supporting us, and because I feel good, and yeah, hopefully give more shit away in the future, and yeah, that's it, that's why I wanted to give away some free shit, and any post you want. Jungle Beats Radio, you can find us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.
Yeah.
I'm Alexander
the man.
We appreciate every single one of you for sticking with us.
100.
100. We're trying to do some big things in the future.
Yeah, man, stay tuned. Anything that comes out, leave it all your thoughts and shit you want us to do.
Yeah.
Pretty much anything hot that's dropping, we'll be doing it.
Hey, we're going to do our best.
We're doing it.
It's tough to get, see all the, there's a lot of requests, so we're going to get to it, yeah. But thank you. So yeah, once again, Instagram, Twitter, we're going to pick a couple of random followers. And give you some free shit, some free posters, if you're fucking with it. And, whoa! Hold up. I forgot. You see, it's why you gotta tune into the end. Everybody get 10% off with the code JungleBeatsRadio. 10% off anything you want, the whole order. 10% off JungleBeatsRadio. If you're fucking with that. That's it for whenisee.com. Okay?
And also, don't be mad if we don't, like ask your comments. If you're asking for something that you want us to do, if we don't answer back, we've probably already fucking heard it, because we get so much for stuff that we've already heard.
Fucking like Logic a thousand times.
Suicide Boys. I mean,
you heard it.
I've heard all their shit, though.
So that changes.
I'm a fan of their shit.
Yeah. Anyway, Jungle Beats Radio. We're done, man. Let's get to the fucking Lupe Fiasco.
Drogas. Lights. Let's hit it.
Can you get... Oh, okay. I can hit that now.
I got the last burp in there. That's good.